Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Uzma Jafri. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 19th of November. Indian PM Modi repeals controversial farm laws in surprise victory for protesters. Burning crop waste fuels pollution in Pakistan's Lahore city. And devotees across India celebrate 552nd birth anniversary of Sikhism's founder Guru Nanak. And now for all the details. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi said on Friday he would repeal controversial farm laws that farmers have protested for more than a year, a significant climb down by the government as important elections loom. Farmer leaders welcomed the move but said their agitation would continue until all their demands, including a law on minimum support price for their produce, are met. Meanwhile, the opposition lamented that the decision came after around 700 farmers died during the protests.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi said on Friday he would repeal three controversial farm laws that farmers have been protesting against for more than a year. In an address to the nation, Prime Minister Modi urged the farmers to go back to their homes and end their nationwide agitation that also drew in activists and celebrities from India and abroad and sometimes broke into violence. The government has said the reforms introduced in September last year meant new opportunities for farmers as they let themselves produce beyond government-backed wholesale markets. But small farmers fear the changes would have made them vulnerable to competition from big retailers.
आज मैं आपको पूरे देश को ये बताने आया हूँ कि हमने तीन कृषि कानूनों को वापस लेने का रिपील करने का निर्णय लिया है। इस महीने के अंत में शुरू होने जा रहे संसद सत्र में इसी महीने में हम तीनों कृषि कानूनों को रिपील करने की संवैधानिक प्रक्रिया को पूरा कर देंगे।
Farmers who have camped at the borders of capital New Delhi since last November welcomed the move by dancing, exchanging sweets and holding prayers. But their leaders said the agitation would continue until all other issues are addressed, including a law on minimum support price for their produce.
ये किसान जब तक समाधान इनका नहीं होगा, ये legal guarantee कानून नहीं मिलेगा हमको, कागज नहीं इसके मिलेंगे, ये पार्लियामेंट में जाएगा, आप रखो पार्लियामेंट, इसको खत्म करवाओ दो दिन में, आगे एक बातचीत करो, MSP पे गारंटी कानून दो, वो एक बड़ा सवाल है, पूरे देश का मसला है।
Although the opposition parties welcomed the repeal of farm laws, the Congress party blamed the center for deaths of around 700 farmers during the protest. The surprise move came just ahead of elections early next year in three northern states with large rural populations.
India's Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar said on Friday that India and China are going through a particularly bad patch in their ties because Beijing has taken a set of actions in violation of agreements for which it still has no credible explanation. Jaishankar made the remarks in an apparent reference to ongoing border row with China in eastern Ladakh region.
India's Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar said on Friday that India and China are going through a particularly bad patch in their ties because Beijing has taken a set of actions in violation of agreements for which it still has no credible explanation. Jaishankar made the remarks in an apparent reference to the ongoing border row with China in eastern Ladakh region while speaking at the Bloomberg New Economic Forum in Singapore. He said it is for the Chinese leadership to answer where they want to take the bilateral relationship.
We're going through a particularly bad patch in our relationship because they've taken a set of actions in violation of agreements for which they still don't have a credible explanation. And that appears to indicate some rethink about where they want to take our relationship.
This comes as India and China agreed on Thursday to find an early resolution to the remaining issues, including disengagement along the line of actual control in eastern Ladakh, a month after failed military-level talks that led to a hardening of positions on both sides. Thousands of Indian and Chinese troops have been locked in the high-altitude face-off in the Ladakh region since last year.
Pakistan's Information Minister Fawad Chaudhry has said Pakistan faces threats from within the country in reference to the rising religious extremism in recent weeks. He claimed that neither Prime Minister Imran Khan's government nor the state was prepared enough to deal with the problem, and the government had to retreat while dealing with the Islamist group TLP, the Tehreek-e-Labbaik Pakistan. His remarks came on the same day as Pakistan released TLP chief Saad Rizvi on Thursday, weeks after the government reached an agreement with the group following days of clashes in mid-October that killed at least 7 policemen and injured scores on both sides. The government also agreed to free over 2,000 detained members of the TLP movement and lifted a ban on the group, allowing it to contest elections. In return, TLP agreed to withdraw a demand to have French ambassador expelled over the publication of caricatures of the Prophet Muhammad by a French magazine, negotiators have said. Lahore, a bustling megacity in Pakistan's Punjab province near the border with India, was declared the most polluted city in the world by Swiss Air Quality Monitor this week. The city continues to experience acute air pollution as residents plead with officials to take action. Air pollution has worsened in Pakistan in recent years as smoke from seasonal crop burn off and colder winter temperatures coalesce into stagnant clouds of smog.
The Pakistan city of Lahore, close to the country's border with India, continued to experience acute air pollution on Thursday, a day after it was declared the most polluted city in the world by an air quality monitor. The city of 11 million and capital of Pakistan's Punjab province is consistently ranked one of the world's worst cities for air pollution. Local residents said burning crop waste was causing smog in Lahore and in neighboring India. And other factors like garbage and cutting down of trees have also contributed to the choking pollution.
आप मोटरवे पे जाएं, गंदम की कटाई हुई है और गंदम की कटाई की वजह से लोगों ने उसको जो उसका भूसा है उसको आग लगा दी है, खेतों में आग लगाई हुई है. और ये सिर्फ हमारे पाकिस्तान में नहीं है, हमारे हमसाया मुल्क में भी ऐसे ही हो रहा है. और जिसका धुआं हमारे मुल्क में आ रहा है और हमारे मुल्क का धुआं हमारे हमसाया मुल्क में जा रहा है.
Authorities in Pakistan have been slow to act, but Additional Secretary of the Agriculture Task Force of Punjab Province issued a video message to public, warning of the risk to physical and mental health from air pollution.
Smog ke na sirf har umar ke logon ke liye nuksanat hain, balki ye jo boodhe log hain aur hamare bacche hain, unke liye to iske jo asraat hain wo aur bhi zyada sangeen hain. याद रखिए कि हमारे इन दिनों में दिल के अमराज हैं उनमें इजाफा हो जाता है, फिर सांस से मुतल्लिक अमराज हैं उनमें इजाफा हो जाता है, फिर फेफड़े मुतासर होते हैं और फॉग स्मोक की वजह से एंग्जाइटी और डिप्रेशन जैसे.
November usually brings worsening pollution with a surge in the concentration of tiny airborne particles, partly because farmers burn crop waste ahead of a new sowing season. In India, as choking smog enveloped capital New Delhi, the city of 20 million people this month, its government initiated a clutch of measures such as shutting down schools, banning construction and garbage burning, and allowing people to work from home. Indian government has also shut down 5 coal-fired power plants around New Delhi.
Months after seizing Kabul in August, the Taliban face daunting problems as they seek to convert their lightning military victory into a durable peacetime government. On Thursday, Taliban's acting foreign minister Amir Khan Muttaqi held talks with joint special representatives from Germany and Netherlands in capital Kabul to discuss humanitarian aid and future political relations.
The Taliban's acting foreign minister Amir Khan Muttaqi held talks with joint special representatives from Germany and Netherlands in Kabul on Thursday to discuss humanitarian aid and future political relations, according to a foreign ministry spokesperson. Taliban foreign ministry spokesperson Abdul Kahar Balkhi on Twitter said the German-Dutch joint delegation discussed humanitarian aid and future political relations with the new Afghan government and promised to find a way to pay teachers and health workers' salaries. Muttaqi recommended in the meeting with the special representatives Jesper Weg from Germany and Emile de Bont from Netherlands that assisted funds should be directly deposited into the bank accounts of the employees to avoid additional costs and delays. The first and second deputies of the Prime Minister, Mullah Abdul Ghani Baradar and Abdul Salam Hanafi, also met the joint special representatives on Thursday. According to Inamullah Samangani, deputy spokesman for the Islamic Emirate, the Afghan officials discussed bilateral relations with the German and Dutch envoys. Baradar once again stressed the need to release Afghanistan's bank assets. Months after seizing Kabul in August, the Taliban faced daunting problems as they seek to convert their lightning military victory into a durable peacetime government. After four decades of war and the deaths of tens of thousands of people, security has largely improved, but Afghanistan's economy is in ruins despite hundreds of billions of dollars in development spending over the past 20 years.
Celebrated since the 17th century, Nepal's dance drama festival Kartik Nach witnesses ancient, unique storytelling art form. The week-long festival, celebrated annually, came to an end with a rhythmic play on Thursday. Meanwhile, in neighboring India, devotees were seen taking holy dips and offering prayers across the country to mark the auspicious occasion of Kartik Purnima, the full moon night of Kartik month.
The week-long dance-drama festival Kartik Naj in Nepal concluded with a rhythmic play at the main Patan Palace Square in capital Kathmandu on Thursday. The festival, which is celebrated every year in Nepali month of Kartik, that is October to November, witnessed scores of spectators despite the winter season. The festival's amalgamative form of dance and drama has been preserved by a local community Neva of the ancient city of Lalitpur. Celebrated since the 17th century, it is an ancient storytelling art form synchronizing with cultural dance and music, which attracts people from various walks of life. Meanwhile, devotees were seen taking dips in the holy rivers and offering prayers in parts of northern and eastern India on Friday to mark the auspicious occasion of Kartik Purnima. Kartik is the eighth and holiest of all lunar months as per Hindu calendar. The full moon day in the Hindu month of Kartik is referred to as Kartik Purnima. It is considered as the most auspicious day to worship Lord Shiva, the Hindu god of destruction, and seek his blessings.
Sikh devotees offered prayers at the famous Golden Temple and their places of worship across India to celebrate the 552nd birth anniversary of Sikhism's founder Guru Nanak Dev. The devotees took holy dips, lit candles and lamps, and pondered upon the spiritual leader's teachings to mark the occasion.
Scores of devotees gathered at the famous Golden Temple in India's northern Amritsar city on Friday to offer prayers and celebrate the 552nd birth anniversary of Sikhism founder Guru Nanak Dev. The devotees took holy dips, lit candles and lamps, and pondered upon the spiritual leader's life and teachings to mark the occasion. Sikhism originated with the birth of Guru Nanak in 1469, who was succeeded by nine other spiritual leaders. The main teachings of Guru Nanak are summed in the simple imperatives of Kirat Karo, Naam Japo and Vand Chako, which means earn your living with honest means, meditate on the God's name and serve others.
ਬੜੀ ਸ਼ਰਧਾ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਸਾਰੀ ਲੋਕ ਭਲਾਈ ਦੇ ਵਾਸਤੇ ਅਰਦਾਸ ਕਰਦੇ ਆ ਕਿ ਸਾਰਿਆਂ ਦੀ ਚੜ੍ਹਦੀ ਕਲਾ ਹੋਵੇ।
Similar scenes were witnessed in gurudwaras or Sikh places of worship in other parts of India. Majority of Sikhs, who form 2% of the country's more than 1.3 billion population, reside in the northern Punjab state and capital New Delhi.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend. Good night.